How long would it take you to die on these planets? One day we will have to leave the Earth. The sun will become bigger and bigger, and we will have to escape the solar system. This is what we know for sure, and this is what will happen in some billions of years unless we manage to destroy our planet before nature follows its inevitable course. That's one of the reasons scientists are looking for exoplanets and habitable places in the universe. But is there any place like Earth? For example, what would a day look like on the other planets of our solar system? Come and find out. Mercury. If you happen to visit Mercury, you will experience a smaller gravitational field, which means your mass will still be the same, but you would feel way lighter than you feel here on Earth. This is because Mercury is the smallest planet in our solar system. It is located only 36 million miles, 58 million kilometers, from the Sun and is a rocky planet. Despite being this close to the star, Mercury still seems to have room for volatile components, which are basically found only in the atmosphere, composed of oxygen, sodium, hydrogen, helium, and potassium. Despite its proximity to the Sun, Mercury is not the hottest planet in our solar system. That title belongs to nearby Venus, due to its denser atmosphere. Even though a day on Mercury equals about 59 days on Earth, your trip wouldn't last anywhere near that long. This is because of the strange changes in temperature that you would experience. The sunny half of Mercury reaches 430 degrees Celsius. It's really hot. But on the other side, the dark one, temperatures drop to a minus 180 degrees Celsius. Your best bet would be to find a cozy spot somewhere in between. But I wouldn't want to recommend you do that, because you wouldn't be able to breathe on this planet. The specific atmosphere of Mercury won't allow you to live more than 2 minutes. Maybe it's better to see what the odds of surviving are on Venus. First of all, I'm sorry to inform you that, although you won't be bored on Venus, it would feel like you are, because one day on Venus is 243 Earth days long. It's true. The rotation of Venus is such that the planet orbits around its axis in 243 Earth days. Also, you should expect it to be very hot, because as we said before, Venus is the hottest planet in the solar system. Its maximum temperature reaches something like 475 degrees Celsius. Basically, if we ever decided to land on Venus, we should first make sure that we have a really robust spacecraft, or it would melt. But even if we managed to land on the surface, we would have a hard time breathing. In fact, the amount of carbon in Venus's atmosphere is ridiculously high. It's about 154,000 times more than the amount of carbon here in the Earth's atmosphere. Also, the clouds are made of sulfuric acid, which gives them that peculiar yellow color. Oh, I forgot to say that sulfuric acid is toxic, so I don't think it would be a great idea to live there. I mean, you would probably be dead in a matter of seconds. Mars. As is generally accepted, Mars could be our new home. But could it really be? Well, maybe yes, if we manage to make some adjustments to its atmosphere. First of all, we would be happy because on Mars a day lasts a bit more than 24 hours, so the time scale is quite similar to the one we are used to as humans. But this evil atmosphere would kill us, because it is mainly composed of carbon dioxide, argon, nitrogen, and a little bit of oxygen and water vapor. Last but not least, we should take a look at the temperatures on Mars. This place is really cold. The average temperature on the red planet is minus 62 degrees Celsius. NASA is already considering what kind of habitation we'll need to survive on the surface of Mars. Six companies began designing possible habitat prototypes in 2016, with completed prototypes expected in 24 months. All these habitats will likely have a few things in common. They have to be self-sustaining, sealed against the thin atmosphere and capable of supporting life for extended periods without support from Earth. To get an idea of what to expect, think about the International Space Station. We'll need things like environmental control and life support systems, power systems, docking ports, and airlocks so that crew can perform spacewalks to repair things that break or to add new capabilities. Expect big, robust equipment to travel across the stars to Mars during the first manned mission, and whatever the astronauts use needs to be up for the long journey. Jupiter. Although it is a difficult thing to accomplish, we could in theory land on Mercury, Venus, and Mars if we have really robust spaceships. But what if I told you there's no chance of landing on Jupiter? It's true. Jupiter is a gas giant, and it doesn't have solid ground to land on. It's a huge ball of gas that some scientists have referred to as a failed star. The amount of gas is so huge that this planet is more than twice as massive as all the other planets in our solar system combined, and there's no rocky contribution. The main components of its atmosphere are hydrogen, helium, and cold, windy clouds of ammonia and water. What we can do is orbit Jupiter, fly by it, as for example the Juno mission did along a polar orbit. Jupiter rotates really fast. One day lasts something like 10 Earth hours. Also, I don't know if you noticed the huge red spot on Jupiter, but that's actually a storm. And the bad news is, that storm is bigger than Earth, believe it or not. It's called the Great Red Spot. If you fall into Jupiter, you'll quickly hit the denser atmosphere below, which will hit you like a wall. It won't be enough to stop you, though. After about 3 minutes, you'll reach the cloud tops, 155 miles, 250 kilometers down. Here, you'll experience the full brunt of Jupiter's rotation. Jupiter is the fastest rotating planet in our solar system. One day lasts about 9.5 Earth hours. This creates powerful winds that can whip around the planet at more than 300 miles or 482 kilometers per hour. About 75 miles or 120 kilometers below the clouds, you reach the limit of our current exploration. The Galileo probe made it this far when it dove into Jupiter's atmosphere in 1995. It only lasted 58 minutes before losing contact and was eventually destroyed by the crushing pressures. If you made it 429 miles or 692 kilometers down, you would find pressure levels higher than at the bottom of the Mariana Trench, the deepest place on Earth. You wouldn't survive on Jupiter for 1 second, let alone the fact that the temperature is lower than minus 140 degrees Celsius. Saturn. Saturn, just like Jupiter, is another giant without a surface. Winds on Saturn reach up to 1,118 miles per hour or 1,800 kilometers per hour, and I doubt you would make it through them alive. But even if you did, you would need to breathe at a certain point, and that's the real trouble. The atmosphere would be unbreathable because it is made of hydrogen and helium. If you are a warm weather person or looking for a balmy place to retire, you might consider building your home in Saturn's interior. Even though Saturn is a frozen world sitting 887 million miles or 1,427 million kilometers from the Sun, its core is scorching hot. But maybe you would have more luck on one of its moons. For example, take Enceladus. This small icy moon captured the imaginations of people worldwide when NASA's Cassini spacecraft saw it spewing plumes of water into space. This water comes from a global liquid ocean concealed beneath Enceladus's fissured crust. As Cassini flew through Enceladus's plumes between 2008 to 2015, its mass spectrometer found a variety of organic molecules, building blocks of life coming from the moon's ocean. Cassini also detected molecular hydrogen, carbon dioxide, methane, and rock fragments hiding within the moon's plumes. Who said that the most comfortable place for us is a planet? Maybe we could live on a moon. Uranus. Let's move on to Uranus. Uranus has a day that lasts about 17 hours, which isn't too far off from ours. But of course, there's again no landing here. And if you dove into its atmosphere, you wouldn't be able to breathe. If you did manage to dive into its atmosphere, though, to your surprise, you would notice blue skies, just like home, sweet home. Yet blue skies on Uranus differ dramatically from Earth because here, deadly abundances of methane gas are the cause of these beautiful blue skies. Helium, methane, and hydrogen are an evil combination of elements for an atmosphere. Also, fun fact, if you could smell it, it would smell like rotten eggs. Oh, and if you often wish the summer would last more here on Earth, then living on Uranus might be the ideal situation for you, because it lasts something like 41 years. But if you ever watched the sky with a telescope from your new home, you might notice a pale blue dot, Earth. You might therefore get homesick. And I'm sorry to inform you, the drive back to Earth to visit friends at highway speeds will take around 43 million hours. Neptune. Last but not least, Neptune. How would we survive on it? First things first, there is no on Neptune. There's only in Neptune. Neptune is a gas planet with no surface. To survive inside Neptune, you couldn't go too deep because the heat and pressure would get you. You'd need everything you need to survive anywhere hostile. Air, water, food, energy, waste disposal, a system to keep the high pressure out or in if you were very high in its atmosphere. In addition, on Neptune, you'd need some kind of flotation system so as not to sink deeper into its atmosphere. For you to die here, it would take less than a second. Neptune has a bunch of ways to kill you. Gravity, radiation, unbreathable atmosphere, atmospheric pressure, and cold. It is a true serial killer. Well, that's pretty much all I have to tell you. So now, after freaking out about all the ways you could die on other planets, why not calm down and just appreciate what we have here on Earth? Earth seems to be the perfect place to live. We have a nice atmosphere that allows us to breathe hassle-free. We have the perfect distance from the sun, which gives us energy and perfectly regulates our sleeping patterns. It is also the only planet where we have Coke. So hopefully, we won't destroy our planet. And if we do manage to, we wouldn't have too many opportunities to find a suitable home anytime soon. Scientists are, of course, working on that. But even if we found some extra solar planet that seems good for hosting life, the problem would be how to reach it in a reasonable amount of time. Probably, it's all a matter of technology, and we just have to wait until someone comes up with a clever idea. Until then, the only thing we can do is treat our planet well. Thanks for watching.